golfers have a very high level of, they expect a very high level of maintenance when they go onto a golf course putting green. Even 1% disease would be considered unacceptable, because 1% disease is actually a lot when you're looking for a perfect roll of the golf ball. Golfers expect to have very little blemishes, if any at all.
You can see the fungus is growing, this white stuff around the edge of the disease patch is really active, and it's really cottony and thick, and you can like really literally pick it up with your finger. So what we're trying to do is find a way to manage, control this disease without using fungicides. So we have quite a few different techniques.
So I just need to mix up this bottle real quick. It doesn't take very long. With these alternative products, we're finding that when we're mixing the mineral oil and the sulfur and the phosphite and the rolling together, in the end we actually are using less pesticide than what we would have done in the...
Let's see. So actually I have this, it's kind of a, it is a little bit like Ghostbusters, isn't it? So I have like this string here that tells me the height I need to stay. So that little piece of steel is hanging from a string, and it needs to just barely scrape the top of the grass. And then you can hear the metronome in the background. So there we go.
So when you put all of them together, it does pretty well. So we're pretty excited.
If you take a step back, you can see just how much disease is around those plots. And then here you have this plot here that has very little disease, and it, frankly, that's remarkable. I think they're just trying to prepare for when the chemicals won't be available. And then there's also perhaps, I think golf course superintendents, they feel like they're kind of stewards of the environment, and they only want to apply fungicides when it's absolutely necessary. And there's also public pressure that is pushing us in that direction as well. We don't know that it's going to like be a long-term solution forever, but we can definitely reduce the amount of fungicides we apply to turf, so that's good.